Thank you, everybody. So yeah, we are the younger company, only 1.5 years. And we believe that farmers are great. They're doing a great job. The only problem is that unlike many years ago when they farmed like 100 trees, they could give nicknames to every tree in the morning and say hello. Today, they are sometimes dealing with hundreds of thousands of trees and even millions of trees. So this caused to many losses. They could not see the trees. They lose a lot of money because of pests in the disease that could devastate the entire farm. They have a lot of non-producing trees that continue to invest on these trees without getting any revenue, unperforming trees, and so on and so on. And obviously also the fruit that nobody here mentioned so far, they're not doing any optimization with the fruit because they don't know how much fruit that they have, what sizes, and so on. So SeeTree decided to try to help them to optimize everything the trees does, and we are doing that by providing the first intelligence network for trees. What does it mean? That we create and provide intelligence per any individual tree. It's like we provide medical records for every tree, productivity records for every tree. This is how everything starts. Very much as you have each of you medical record, we believe that each of flowers is different, each of trees is different, and you desire to have the same kind of treatment. So the service is basically is focused on three main pillars: 3Ls, fruit optimization, and farming efficiency. When it's come to 3Ls, what we did is that we start by providing them a very accurate and persistent score, L score, for every single tree, representing by different colors, which allow us to see the small differences from month to month for what is the health condition of the trees, and then recognize that this tree is not performing well. And the fact is that trees, that farmers, that really they don't care about data. This is the reality. If you speak with them, they tell you they don't care about data, even not actionable data. They really care about something super simple, about profit. And what we provide them on almost everything that they do in the farm is example on how they lose money, how much they lose, and how basically they could solve the problem. And sometimes, obviously, it's required to not just highlight that there is a problem, you need to go to the root cause of the problem. And honestly, it changed a lot in the same farm from one area to another. The second thing that we do is that we think, okay, tree is not just for having a beautiful image, is to produce fruit. So currently, they're not doing any optimization whatsoever on the fruit. And after all, tree is a production unit. So we basically detect the amount of fruit, the size of the fruit, and many months ahead of the harvesting time, which provide them a lot of insight that they could use to prepare the harvesting and also to tweak the amount of fruit and the size of the fruit that could bring them the best revenue. Just to give you a sense, sometimes they could get per acre in trees $12,000 per acre or $3,000 just because the fruit is not optimized. And beyond that, obviously, we could detect alpha trees and allow them to mimic these trees and so on and so on. And in addition, the holy grail of the optimization is to give them different type of recipes that can be used to improve the farming. The last thing that we provide them is a lot of important advice on farming efficiency. The reality is very much as you in any business that you're doing a lot of mistakes, me too, but we have a way to measure these mistakes. Farmers don't. So we provide them the system that give a score for every trees and see the different changes from month to month, allow them to detect the mistakes and also to see what is the output of their actions that they took on the field, and so on. And last but not least, because we provide like the surrounding efficiency information, eventually it will feed the machinery to do a real precision agriculture. So how we do this magic? So yes, the lady mentioned that introduced me that one of my dear CEO
He has a very unique background that unfortunately I could not share with you. But I could say that he deals with the most sophisticated intelligence network that exists in the world for defense. And when we started this company, he said, you know what, in order to bring to farmer the highest level of value, we could not build our solution on a silver bullet sensor, no matter if it's from the ground, from the air, from the underground. So this is what we build. We build a campaign of data collection that we are basically operate completely, which using different type of tool from the air, from the ground, and from the underground to collect the data in order to reach the highest level of detection to be able to reach the highest level of value, and so on. So we use military-grade drones that fly much more than DJI, sensors which are very advanced, which are not widely available in the market. The smiley is on the thing that we are doing on the ground that we are not exposing, but we have another, let's call it vehicle, robot, whatever you want to call it, on the ground, and also underground sensor like the one that you saw before, and so on. But the thing that I'm proud most is the boots on the ground. As part of the intelligent gathering, we are not shy to say that we are also using people, human, to give us the last part of the investigation, send them to a very specific point to take like a leaf sampling, soil sampling, and so on and so on. So this is about the data gathering. Now about the analysis about this data. So I'm quite involved in the last few years with Google and Silicon Valley, and I was exposed to many leading applied machine learning companies. And one thing that I learned is that the best combination when you want to disrupt industry with applied machine learning is when you combine, you take the best from artificial intelligence and human intelligence and put it together, and not just try to replace human and use it without them. So what we build is the same process in the analysis. So we build a remote agronomy center, which gets all this amazing information, high resolution, different angle, from the air, from the ground, from the underground, and do a lot of stuff to provide us this great calibration to the AI and preparation of the data set and so on. And also we use top-tier agronomists, again, sent to very specific place to complete the intelligence. And last but not least, obviously AI. We're very pleased to have an amazing team from Mobileye. If you saw Ocam, that's spent all their career in the last 13 years in Mobileye. So definitely they're using that in a smart way.
Your trees, they're magnificent. But how well do you actually know them individually? Meet SeeTree, the intelligence network for trees. Gain insight into the health and productivity of your trees. We combine data from our machine learning algorithms with boots on the ground to help you optimize your farming operations. Let's work together and make better agronomic decisions to increase the profitability of your farm.
So, every company that provides any data to the world of farming, speak about digital farming, we believe that in the world of trees, the architecture of this digital farming should be all around the trees. And then you could add all the other layers of the machinery and like sensor and so on. And this is what we do, and we are the only one that are doing that. And we believe that thus we need to provide this file per every tree, and also a new fashion of newsfeed, which we create like very much like a social networks of the trees. Every tree has a feed, every combination of trees has a feed, and so on. And this is mainly thanks to the fact that the Waste Founder is one of our investors, but also from the fact that with SeeTree, you could navigate to a specific tree which has some problems and basically take notes and so on. We started 18 months ago. We started laser focus, California, citrus only. Then we moved to Brazil, and now California growers push us to almond. We started a huge project in Indonesia, and soon we'll start more crops in Chile and others, growing very fast. And about the ROI, I will not go overall, but I will say that any farming activity, we try basically to optimize with this data. Last and not least, I think that one of the reasons that this company is succeeding to execute so well is thanks to my great founders and teams. Each of them behave like the CEO, although we have the best CEO in town, my partner is Sahil. Even though that we are 18 months, we have very nice revenue and gaining traction with the leading growers anywhere we act with zero salespeople. So with that, I would like to thank you everyone and have a great day. Thanks.